You want to believe it.
Is he
not real?
Is he there?
You're alone in these mountains.
Is that Lydia?
Nothing lives here. You won't survive. You met him by the tree.
She met him by the tree.
Maybe it's a sign, the tree.
What's he trying to tell you?
He's waiting for you by the tree.
The Northmen tell of a great hero. His name is Sigmund. His father's hall was built around a great tree, and one day, Odin comes and thrusts a sword into the tree, a gift to whomever. His brother, King Sigmund, wants him, but Sigmund refuses him. So King Siggeir plots revenge. He invites Sigmund and his brothers to a feast. But when they arrive, they are met with an army.
Take it.
Forced the dwarves to make a sword that would never fail and never rust, and that would slice through iron and stone and bring victory to its bearer. But the angry dwarves cursed it. It would be the death of a man every time it was drawn, and it would be the death of the king. Let me tell you about the sword Tyrving.
I don't recognize this place. Where are we? Where is she?
It feels wrong. Where are we now? Burial mound. It's so strange that we go to such lengths to bury death. Something so very ordinary. Inevitable. It's as if we conspire to hide death. Because we have no answer for it. But when it comes and forces itself onto our friends or loved ones, then comes the reckoning.
Who teaches herself to fight with weapons. When she learns where her father is buried, her only desire is to reclaim the treasure buried with him, but above all, the sword, Tyrving.
Careful, you have to be able to see.
I'm here for the trials. Like when we first met, remember? I'll find him.
What's that? Did you hear that?
Nothing. Don't touch the walls.
You don't know what they might do.
Turn back.
She has to keep going.
It's not safe here.
She has to keep going.
If you go down there, no one can save you.
It's too scary.
Find another way. It's not working.
You have to use your mind. Where can you go?
You're failing. Find another
Think.
Way.
Think. Focus.
I can hear him.
Hervor disguises herself as a man to join a band of warriors, and soon becomes their leader. When they come to the island where her father is buried, her men do not want to go ashore. They say that evil haunts the island, and that it is a worse place by day than other places are by night. Fearless, she lands alone. There are many grave mounds, and all of them have ghostly flames burning over them. She comes to the grave mound of her father after passing through these ghostly fires as though they were mist. The flames I passed through were real enough. Damn the Northmen to hell.
I'm leaving. I've decided. I think it will be good for me.
It's the darkness. It's speaking through.
No, Dad, it's me. I think I can beat it in my own way.
I can see the darkness in your eyes, child.
I met a boy.
Boy.
The chief fencer.
No.
He said he could help me.
It's a trick.
He said it could be normal.
Normal?
Yes.
No boy is going to save you. No one can. When they see the rot growing inside you,
no.
They will turn their back on you. The gods can only fix you through my hand. You're going nowhere.
No.
You will not defy the gods. Come, child, take my hand. Come. Senua.
No! I am leaving!
cannot escape the darkness. Your curse will make everyone suffer. You will have blood on your hands!
Say that their all-father, Odin, gave his eye in exchange for a drink from Mimir's well, the Well of Wisdom. In blindness there can be wisdom. Only by giving can you receive in return. For this reason, I give my life and pass on my stories of the Northmen to you, Senua.
Where am I? I can't see. Who's there?
Can you hear me?
Dillian.
I'm right here. Can't you see me?
No. Help me.
Breathe slow.
It's the darkness.
Stay still. Empty your thoughts. Tell me what you feel.
A breeze.
Good. Then there is a way out.
I can't tell where it comes from.
Yes, you can.
The others. The voices, they've gone.
I'm still here.
It's so quiet. So dark.
It's okay. Listen to your own breath. Feel it rise and fall. Good. Be aware of everything you hear and feel. Let your senses guide you.
I'm somewhere else now. But the breeze has gone.
Use all of your senses. Let the world speak to you. What do you hear?
I hear water.
Good.
I've reached the water.
Good. That's your way out. Follow it upstream.
I'm so sorry. I thought I left this all behind.
Don't be sorry. It's not your fault.
He was right. It's inside of me. It won't let me go.
Senua. My father. He taught me that the hardest battles are fought in the mind, not the soul. You're no coward. You proved that to me in the warrior trials. This is just another battle. You can beat it.
This isn't your battle. You don't have to help me.
I want to. Besides, you are going to be a great warrior one day. You need people like you.
Okay. I'll do my best. Not following me.
Leave it behind and keep moving forwards. Darkness is testing you, but you are in control.
as well.
Don't turn back. You're getting close.
Tilly. Help me.
She could spend hours, days even, trapped within herself, in the dark.
You see me?
Yes.
Your eyes were open, but you were gone.
And when it finally let her go, she could be anywhere. With no memory of how she got there.
When it comes for me, I have no power over it.
But here, for the first time, someone was there to help.
But I heard your voice. You brought me back.
You found your own way back. All you needed was a little help. A little hope.
You're wrong.
What has nothing to do with the sword?
What if we're wrong?
The sword will never be yours.
What if this is the end?
It's just a trick. It's just a test.
You've been fooled before. You could be fooled again.
You're being tested.
You don't know. It's just their game.
I want to tell you a story about a god of the Northmen called Baldur. The second son of Odin. He was beautiful, good and wise. He was fair of feature, he spoke fair words, he gave fair judgments. Light shone from him. Only good things were told of him. Yet he was the first of the gods to die.
You can feel me. You can feel his presence. You need the runes to find Dillian.
You need Dillian.
He's waiting for you.
He always said he'd wait.
He's close.
He cares about you.
He loves you. Calling you.
Dillian. Dillian, we're here.
Dillian.
Dillian. We're nearly here. We're coming.
Dillian, there he is.
There he is.
What are you waiting for?
Quick, find him.
Where is he?
Where has he gone?
We're in the wrong world.
He's not here.
She's in the wrong world.
He's not in this world.
He's in the other one. He's in the other one. He's in the dark world.
The dark.
The dark.
The world once seemed so simple. Black and white. Darkness and light. Narrow dividing lines of our own making. Dillian taught her to see further. To peek through the cracks and see the worlds of color stretching away from the gloom. And Senno explored new paths into the unknown.
Why isn't he here? He's gone. He's in the dark.
The Northmen tell this story about the death of Baldur. It begins with dark dreams. Night after night, Baldur dreams of his own death, and the gods fear for his life. So Baldur's...
light within her worship. She is pure darkness.
Years had passed since she left her father.
She trained hard alongside her friend.
She saw things no one else could. Patterns, shapes, with knowledge. An intuition that made her an exceptional warrior. Friendship turned to love. But the shadow of darkness never let her go, and she was caught between two worlds. That of Zinbel and her past. And Dillian's.
And now the future.
Two realities tearing at her soul.
East Indian, you have no time for this. Speed these traps. These traps mean nothing. It's all part of their game.
They've sent you trials to distract you.
They've set you up, you, and now they're going to watch you.
What if these trials mean nothing within you?
Laughing at you.
What if they take you no closer to Dillian?
Overcome with grief, the gods send Hermod to ride to Hel and ask Hela to let Baldur return home. All the gods are dying, he says. Are they? Asks Hela. We shall see if he is truly missed.
He's the reason.
If everything in the world will weep for him, he shall go back to the gods. But if even one thing refuses, Baldur stays with me. The gods send messengers everywhere.
When you had the chance.
Why didn't you listen to him?
His love has tortured you and the world through his eyes. Slowly,
do it, Simon.
Senua, your father cannot understand your darkness. He cannot see through your eyes. No one can. My own father was born blind. Doesn't have the faintest idea of what the night looks like. The word dark to him means as little as the word light. So someone is afraid of the dark. Should we fix them by taking away their sight? Would you give up the beautiful world that you, and only you, can see just to be rid of your nightmares? Or is
killing
this the
you
price
would
you
be
pay
too easy.
Gift you have?
They're taking your memories to torture you. They're taking your memories.
Gift makes you so special
in
life.
One memory. Every time you remember, it disappears.
They're going to take everything.
They're not yours anymore.
They're going to take everything you have.
The memories of ghosts.
They belong to the gods
to protect you.
They're eating you from the inside. They want to kill your soul. They want to crush it.
They want your body. They want your soul.
They want your mind, and they're going to take it.
The memories were yours, but they're the gods now.
Nothing is yours anymore.
It's disappearing with your memories.
I saw once a plague strike northern lands of ice. It was so terrible that not the oldest man among us could remember the like. Hundreds died. The sickness took nearly every person younger than 40 and many older. And where dying mothers gave birth, the marks of the plague were on the babes as they came out of the womb.
Where are we? I don't like it.
This place feels...
What is this place?
This place feels... It's... creepy.
Creepy.
It feels wrong.
It feels strange.
Where is it?
There he is.
There he is.
The light.
Go towards it.
He's in the house.
He's going in. He's disappearing.
Follow him.
Don't let him disappear.
The air.
Where's it gone? Keep going. How do you find it?
Like the old warrior trials. Diane will help me.
The stench of rot. She can almost taste it. Do you smell it? No. Don't worry. Not everyone can. It was a warm spring day when she went to the river with Gillian and the others. But the water. She could taste the rot. Good. She knew something was wrong, something sinister. She begged them to leave, but they just laughed at her. But soon enough, as the bodies piled up, no one was laughing. And they knew that she was not like them.
The Northmen speak of a death moon, a light shaped like a half moon that appears inside a house and goes around the walls. I once saw the death moon appear at a farm, and first the shepherd died, then a guest died, and then the farmhands, and then the farmer and six of his men drowned at sea. But that is not the end of it, because the dead return to haunt the living. If you see the death moon, be death in that house.
You succeeded.
Senua! What happened?
They're blaming me for the plague. They say that I'm cursed. What if they're right?
How would they know such a thing? Are they gods? None of us are. They're just people. Good people, but they're scared. They're afraid of what they can't see. Like children scared of the dark. They make up stories to fill the void. It doesn't make them true.
What if my father was right?
You have to step out of this darkness. Let them see who you really are, like I am. You're not a monster.
Without you, this darkness has made me a monster.
You've done it.
You did it.
The warrior trials.
You need that.
Go get the sword.
You did it for the sword. You have to get the sword.
With Grammar reforged, You will have Odin's blessing to walk a goddess into the halls of Helheim and challenge Hela as an equal.
So Dillion was helping me. And a sword will lead me to him. Like when we first met.
Dillion gave her the strength to pass the warrior trials, and she saw a way out. To leave her past behind, and become a warrior in Dillion's clan.
Go back.
The sword is tainted by the gods of darkness. Leave it.
No. He left it here. He wants me to take it.
You will pay a price for this.
Years later, with Zinbel's parting words still haunting her, the darkness came back with a vengeance. A plague.
Tell you?
Everyone suffered.
My father was not supposed to die like this.
This is your fault.
You brought this plague to us! You have blood on your hands!
They're coming for you now.
They're coming.
Hold the heavy strike. Unleash the sword.
Focus is growing. It's coming back.
Don't give up. She finished. Focus now. You can do it.
Waved through itself over the ones I loved. The ship broke up under them. The ship that had sailed from the land of shining fields. Their memorial stone is sacred. Come not here in the sun. Come not with a sword. Come not crying over a naked corpse. Come not.
Hear the sun disturbed mind. Does your precious gift of sight let you see the souls that rot here in this sea of corpses? Do you feel the blood running cold on your skin? Do you hear their endless cries? Do you smell their putrid wounds? They were once brothers, sisters, and loved ones. And look at what you have done to them. All because you were a coward, because you ran from your curse instead of facing it. When you turned your back on your father, Zinbel, you turned your back on the gods and let the darkness wreak havoc on your people. Why must they pay for your heresy?
She's so weak, they can see you.
hear, Senua? Do you hear the voice of your mother, Galena? She calls for you, Senua. Go to her. Answer her pitiful call.
Darkness took her life, and it will take yours. It's taking you further and further into it.
Focus now. End it.
hands on. Maybe you too should suffer with your brethren in this rot and let your blood seep into the seas and the rivers of hell. Isn't that what you deserve after all you've done? Give the darkness what it wants, let it swallow your soul and destroy all that you are. Why are you fighting for someone who is already dead? Just look around you. What hope is there for you, even if his soul could be rescued? Do you think he will thank you for what you have done to him, to his friends, to his father?
You